The Negative Impact of Information Technology on the Way People Think, a presentation by Group 8. Historically, the influence of new technologies has always been feared. The concerns we express today about the effect of information technologies such as social media on our minds were similarly made about the creation of the printing press in the 16th century and countless other innovations that came after. However, there is a very stark difference in the interconnectivity and wealth of information brought upon us by the digital age compared to previous technologies. As such, the effect on our thinking is extremely significant and has been demonstrated through the behavioral shifts our society has undergone. Our group will be examining the negative effects of technologies such as the internet, social media, and smartphones on our way of thinking. They're examining their self-promotion of addiction, their effect on our cognitive abilities, and their effect on our mental health. Argument 1. People become too dependent on information technology. Due to how easily accessible the internet is, people have become heavily reliant on it, using it to form thoughts in favor of critical thinking. Given that virtually anyone can add content to the internet, it is very easy for untrustworthy sources to advertise false, yet still believable information, which can cause people's opinions and beliefs to be clouded or corrupted by these inaccuracies. For example, a very well-known online source that contains knowledge on various topics is Wikipedia. However, it is known that the articles are written by online volunteers who may not have credible sources. As a result, many industries abstain from allowing their students or workers to use it for research purposes. Misinformation gets especially dangerous when an echo chamber is created, where members feed off a positive feedback loop of the same ideas and ideology, which can create an over-reliance on a single source of information and skew someone's worldview in an unhealthy manner. Finally, the addictive nature of the internet was demonstrated through a study done by UCLA professor Gary Small, who tested the brain activity of veteran and new internet users. It was found that the brains of veteran users showed more activity and released higher amounts of dopamine while browsing the web. This suggests that the information technology is capable of rewiring our brains to experience greater reward while using it, resulting in a positive feedback loop that can result in addiction. Ultimately, the use of information technology mediums promotes a strong cycle of dependence that is difficult to break once it has started. Argument 2. The overuse of information technology has negatively affected cognitive performance. It is an undeniable fact that information technology is a vital medium for which the world operates. It has altered the way people work, live, and relax. Nowadays, most people are spending a majority of their day in front of their computer screens, televisions, or mobile phones. In 2015, an online survey was conducted by Gallup, which found that over 52% of US smartphone owners checked their smartphone several times per hour or more frequently. Although advances in technology has its benefits, many people are becoming too reliant on technology in their daily lives. Therefore, the overuse of information technology has negatively impacted cognitive performance. Nowadays, there is an ever-increasing number of consumer goods on the market. The rise in demand for electronic devices such as iPhones and iPads has led to social media platforms such as Instagram and Twitter taking center stage. It has become more difficult for people to focus and stay on task when they are bombarded by viral content, trends, and messages. A study conducted by Microsoft found that the average attention span has dropped from 12 seconds to 8 seconds. Comparatively, the average attention span of a goldfish was found to be 9 seconds. Moreover, the internet is disproportionately influencing young people. From the study conducted by Microsoft, over 77% of the participants who indicated that their phones were occupying a majority of their attention were between the ages of 18 to 24, which will prevent them. Many of them are exposed to modern technologies such as smartphones, tablets, and video games at an early age and have learned how to incorporate usage of such devices into their daily lives. The overuse of such devices is showing that it could potentially negatively impact their development by decreasing their attention spans and limiting their learning ability, which will prevent them from being able to learn and assimilate new information. The digital age has led to the need for multitasking. People will watch YouTube videos, study course notes, and scroll through the newsfeed on their phones all at the same time. Although this may seem impressive, studies have shown that multitasking can reduce productivity by as much as 40%. One such study was conducted by Stanford University's Media Lab, where various cognitive tests were given to 49 students who multitasked frequently and 52 students who multitasked less. it was found that the heavy multitaskers found it more difficult to switch between tasks when required, as they were more easily distracted and thus performed poorly. Consequently, multitasking decreases concentration and focus, which are necessary for brain efficiency and productivity. Studies have shown that there is a negative correlation between multitasking and GPS. Another concerning trend introduced by information technology is the concept of cognitive offloading, where someone may deem it unnecessary to memorize certain pieces of information due to its accessibility through the internet or smartphone. A study done for the Journal of Trends in Cognitive Sciences found that people who were permitted to take pictures of pieces of art were less likely to remember features than those who were not allowed to take pictures. Similar deterioration of memory can occur through over-reliance on phone reminders to schedule appointments or looking up directions through GPS systems. As technology advances, it is very evident that we are becoming more reliant on information technology, and our own abilities have degraded as a result. Argument 3. Information technology creates feelings of anxiety and inadequacy through social media use, diminishing face-to-face interaction, and providing an unfiltered space for cyberbullying and harassment. Social media interactions between children, teenagers, and adults has led to the exchange of photos, videos, and content, which is carefully edited to highlight and glorify certain lifestyles. These lifestyles are often highly edited and don't accurately represent the poster's life. Users, primarily teens and children, are shown these lifestyles of perfection, which give them an unrealistic expectation of reality, causing them to develop self-esteem issues. These feelings are compounded when social media use increases, as in recent times. In a 2017 study by the Royal Society of Public Health, 1,500 students aged 11 to 25 were asked to track their moods while using popular forms of social media. The researchers found that 7 in 10 students were made to feel worse about their body image, while half of the 14 to 24-year-olds reported popular social media apps exacerbated feelings of anxiety. As the use of information technology increases, there's a widespread decrease in the feeling of personal interaction. This is due to the increase of screen time for young adults, decreasing the need for face-to-face interaction and allowing people to lead more isolated lives. In a study published in the Associate for Psychological Science, it was seen that adolescents who spend more time on social media and electronics seem to be at higher risk of displaying depressive symptoms and suicide-related risk factors. Furthermore, activities such as social media use and video game playing can be key factors of this. The American Journal of Preventive Medicine in 2017 examined whether young people's use of 11 social media sites correlated with their perceived social isolation. The results concluded that increased social media use was strongly and independently associated with the increased perceived social isolation in a nationally representative sample of young adults in the United States. This indicates that although information technology is meant to be used as a tool to connect us, it makes users feel detached from personal connection and society. Lastly, information technology encourages user aggression and harassment through the context of anonymity and lack of accountability. This is primarily seen on social media through cyberbullying and harassment. Information technology tools have made it easier for abusers to access an individual and harass them both in front of their peers and privately. With the increasing use of information technology in schools and by youth, cyberbullying has also increased over the past few years. A study by the UK's media regulator has found bullying of young people online has grown significantly worse in recent years. The report revealed that the proportion of 12 to 15-year-olds who reported having been bullied on social media had nearly doubled from 6% to 11% since 2016. Cyberbullying can lead to isolation, sadness, and fear, creating more depressed users. In conclusion, information technology has promoted unhealthy behavior in our way of thinking through promoting an overdependence on technology, degrading our cognitive abilities, and deteriorating our mental health. It is important that the impacts of these trends are acknowledged and addressed before further consequences are observed.